Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the gracilis muscle. So we can see pictured here the gracilis muscle in isolation, and it's a little bit confusing to understand where it is in relation to other muscles without seeing them all together. So let's switch over to a different view. So you can see I've highlighted the gracilis muscle here in green, and there's two other muscles which insert in close relation to the gracilis muscle. Those two muscles are the sartorius muscle and the semitendinosus muscle. So I'll go over the reason for remembering these three muscle insertions in relation to the gracilis when we go over the insertion next. So you can see I've marked here in blue the insertion of the gracilis muscle, specifically that's on the proximal medial tibia. So next let's go over that relation of the gracilis, the sartorius and the semitendinosus muscle. The reason that they're related is that the three tendons all connect relatively close to each other, and the name of the area where these three tendons connect is called the pes anserinus. So the term pes anserinus is actually Latin, and if you translate it to English, that means goosefoot, and the reason why it's called goosefoot is those three tendons where they're connecting supposedly look somewhat like a goosefoot. So if you imagine how a goosefoot looks, you've got the toes and then you've got the webbing in between. So those three toes would obviously be the three tendons, and then you've got that webbing, which is the tendons and other tissues surrounding those tendons, connecting them all together. So next you can see highlighted here in red the origin of the gracilis muscle, and that's on the pelvis, specifically on the ischiopubic ramus. So we're back again at the skeletal model, and let's take a look at the actions of the gracilis muscle. So the gracilis connects the hip joint to the tibia. So it's going to have actions at both of these joints. It's going to have actions at the knee, and it's going to have actions at the hip. So we'll go over the actions of the hip first. So let's say our leg is abducted like this, and the gracilis is connecting the tibia to the hip. So it's going to pull the tibia towards the hip in this case, and that's going to contribute to adduction. And it's going to be a weak synergist in the movement of adduction. And that's going to be the same for its other action, a flexion at the knee. It's going to weakly synergize and assist other muscles in that movement. So we've got big muscles like the hamstrings, which is going to cause that flexion of the knee joint. But if you watch the tibia right here, comparative to the hip, you can see the tibia moves closer towards the hip. So this means the gracilis muscle is going to be able to assist in that particular movement. As well, if you look at the leg when it's in an externally rotated position, and then you look at the relation of the tibia to the hip, and you imagine the gracilis contracting, that would cause internal rotation or medial rotation of the leg. So internal rotation, medial rotation, two ways of saying the same thing. So that's the last action here, medial rotation of the leg. So if you enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons, really helps our channel. Thanks so much for watching everyone. I'll see you all next time.